Hey, down here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and see about getting that front driver's side tire off. You have to jack it up. Jack stand's already under there to make sure it didn't go down. If that valve stem, this is my 83 Dodge van. If the valve stem is broken on that tire, but figured out I could put a stick in the hubcap to hold it in the right position so it didn't, and it actually doesn't leak. It's been away for months. I don't think it's gone down hardly any. It's not on the jack stand, I don't think. I'll check it again. Anyway, I'm going to jack it up and then I'll get around there and get it off. I'm just down of thirst today. I'm gonna get another drink. Yeah, I was gonna show you. If you don't know what a valve stem is, can you see that? There we go. That is, I've got a whole pack of them because they were just, bought like 8 or 10 of them. It was just good, cheaper to buy them that way. I figured really I could use what the blazer and the van could. I'm not going to do them all. I mean, I probably wouldn't do them unless they broke most likely, but anyway, there's any that could go at any time because they're all old. So there we go. Stuff situated again. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. It's right on the center there. Okay. Hopefully when I go up there I won't block everything from that angle. Am I? Let's see. Well, I could. Now that's good, I think. Okay. I already squirted in the dust buster. I'm not quite exactly sure which size of lugs you're gonna have. Let's see. Plastic hubcap. My uncle gave me this van over 10 years ago, and he's since passed away. But here's the bad one. I can hear it when I touch it. but rusty, so I guess that's why he bought it. I think they were in a box inside when I got it. Anyway, or maybe not all of them were on there or something. Thing is, I would probably paint the wheel or something, but one of the wheels is in one of these counters. I just wanted to put them on there because they look better than the rusty. And it looks. But these, they have hexes all the way out to the end, so you don't have to worry about how deep they are like those ones on my blazer. That is bigger than a 3/4. I think it's going to be bigger than what I got on the gun. I don't think I have anything. So if I don't, that changes everything. Really the perfect size, but there's an extension in there. I remember, right? Oh no, it's not. Let me go look. I don't think it's an extension. I think it's that's what I need is an extension because of that hub cover sticking out there. I gotta go look. Okay, I hate to, the only extension I got are my standard half inch extensions, but I'm going to go ahead and use them. Yeah, the shorter one will do just fine. Okay, let's see if it's good. Good.
didn't lose its air. Those tires were like basically brand new when I got to the van, but they set so long I'm kind of be scared of them if I start driving that again. You know, it cracked, I don't think. Maybe a little bit. Let's hope it's completely rusted. Nah, I'm gonna spray it. Debating about trying to replace that or going ahead and just put the spare on there. It has a spare that's up. I don't know how hard it'll be to get off of it. That's, boy, it's a world of difference taking a tire off with an M-way. I had one, and I'll talk about that some other time. But I hadn't had one since 1975. I didn't need one when I was younger, but I didn't, I don't know. I didn't want bad enough to go out and spend the money. I had the money over the years at different times. Then when I got older and needed one, I couldn't afford it till now. Let's see. I guess we're going around to the back because either I'm going to use the only way I got to breaking a tire down is using the best way I've got is a bumper jack, and this one has a bumper jack, and use the weight of the vehicle to do it. And I got a bunch of, I've got 8 diesel truck batteries in the back of there. I was wanting to, set it up with batteries. So somebody gave me those batteries, and I don't think this coil reached that far. And anyway, they've been in there for years, and they each weigh around 100 pounds. Thinking about checking out that spare. I think I'll check out the spare before. I know this is, I haven't done, fixed the valve, replaced the valve stem in many years. I know it can be really hard to break that loose, break that bead loose. It's easy to get it back as long as you got air pressure to blow it back up, but it's hard to get it loose. So let's look at this spare. Camera up here. And there's a spare. Now, I have to get that cover off of it and then see what it would take with the impact. It might not be too bad. I tire being tightened. Yeah, the tire being tightened onto the cover is holding it. Okay, there's two bolts, and with, yeah, I don't think the shell is going to do it. If I'm going to do this, I'm probably going to be breaking my rules that I had set for myself. Yes, it's recorded. Oh, it fits. Okay, so I can use that. Okay. We're still recording. Plug it. There's a spare. I wanted to check, yeah, it was the way it's on here. And that may be the only way to go on there. I good, I don't know. You couldn't hardly get to that to air it up. You could get to it. Let's see, there's two old nests in there. I was kind of wary of that because for at least 2 years I had the boss nest, even the boss nest in there. Put this on there because I think I'm gonna wear out trying to break this that bead on that. 25 pounds. I'm bringing up to 32. Imagine being that it's cracked, I won't go 35. That stuff's good on it. Other tire on here. There's some wire there, sorry. there trying to get some of that sand off of there, and it starts going on my feet. Let's get that base of the bumper jack this with came with this van. What I do is put this on the bead. I don't know if you can see down there, and jack it up on it. I don't think you could see that, but I imagine you've got the idea by now. I guess that's considered an old fat timey jack now, but that's what I grew up with. Okay, so yeah. While I'm here, I'm going to get the cameras here and everything. I'm going to try to put that up there. And if I can put it up there, okay. Well, that plastic thing would really help me with that. Get all this stuff off of it. Thank you. around the middle like that. If you turn around the other way, it would be worse, wouldn't it? On this wheel, anyway. I wasn't going to get dirty. I promised myself I wasn't going to do anything to get dirty. I lied. Let's get it out of my way. Get this out of the way. I'll just put it in here. I think there's enough room. Bolts weren't going to reach through the holes. I think it would only go up with the old stock wheel. This thing's about ready to go in the trash. It's it might have been its last good use. Crack some more. Yeah, I stuck a bunch of stuff in here. Around to the front. I think I can aim this anywhere any better yet. Let's go ahead and take it. My gloves are so dirty, I'm gonna have to blow them out. So I will get this camera back around on the first. Oops, I always forget that I am running a camera when I'm moving. I just move it. Okay, now it's came loose on me for some reason. This cable's getting tangled around right soon. Now, let's get back to where we were. Yeah. That'll be about right. I Now I'm gonna go get the tools and bring them around. See, we still. I gotta go air, get the air to blow this glove out. Gives out. I'm going to air that tarp before I put it on there because I don't know if it's going to, what if it acts up, if it starts leaking or something. I'm gonna go get my air epping tool and I'm gonna blow. Put some more oil in this. I accidentally did lay it down right in the dirt. I'm gonna. Not gonna do any good. Maybe I'll blow it back out the back. I'll put this somewhere where I can't get in the sand. Got a little valve stem core removing tool that I was thinking I was going to use on that, but I'm going to make sure this one's good and tight. It tightens and removes. Now, see what we got in there. Oh, great. This air checker broke in half. Let's go get another one. Thank you. Okay. My good one is, I think it's working now that I put rust buster in it. 60 pounds. Might be working too good. It's 50 something. I think it made it slide too good. Yeah, it's not even quite 30 on this one. Since those, these and the one that the head broke off of both said about the same, I'm going to go by that. Maybe when this one dries, it'll start working right again. You do not want to just trust one of these, obviously, evidently. Obviously, or whatever. Let's see. Put this one in the can. Okay, let's air you up to 32 pounds, I guess. Now that one takes air like it should. About those bounced ends on my blazer, it seems to have gotten clogged up. And also not as big of a tire, so it won't take as long. I gotta remember that. Especially at 125 pounds of pressure. Yep, that's 32.467. Just that quick. 32.467. I'm gonna go down some because you know, it's fixing to start getting really hot, and I don't want this thing blowing out from overpressure. And if it's been sitting for all those years and it still had about 25 pounds in it, then it hasn't been leaking. Yeah. 32, 4, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, these are 1 PSI, so that's 32 right there. 32. Okay, so let's just put this one on. Yes, I would like to get, first I want to get the carburetor rebuilt and get the blazer back on the road. It needs new tires. About $1,200 worth with the spare, because I need a spare too. Those tires. This one probably does too. Didn't really inspect that tire after all that. Right? But let's get that air going back on there. What did I do with my gloves? I don't know, left them in the garage or something. Can't really get another with my left hand if I use my right. Forward. Now where's my, oh, there they are. There's a good place for them right up there at my camp, so where I can see them when I'm walking around. Okay, so let's get this wheel up on there. And yeah, this, I don't think I'm in any shape to be doing that joust thing. And I wasn't dressed for it either. I was not even planning on doing this. All I was going to do is try that out on the blazer if I could it work. I just got the air pack delivered. Ones for this wheel. I think those are all right. Yeah, I think those are fine. Four of those steel, you know, slotted wheels that have, like, I noticed there were holes. At first I thought they were over-watered out, and then I remembered they made them that way to fit more than one vehicle. Good. Now, that's real common now. Back in my my day, you had to buy the ones that fit your beer. I do remember when they started doing that, but I also remember people having trouble with them. The aluminum ones would water out. And, people didn't know, you know, people got kind of swore away from them. Extension now because I don't have that deep wheel. This is a stock wheel. You only have to line that up. Well, I mean, I guess you would, but. Oh, I didn't ever put any more oil in that, and I'm going to do it this time. Big old oil it, and I'll come back and do that. Well, it's brand new. And I think the very first day I use it, I should put it. Good. I'm still thinking about whether I should get an inline oiler. The thing is, most of them with my air compressors, blow my clothes and my face off with it. You don't want oil in your face, for sure, so one reason why I don't want to do that. And I do that often, that air impact, I won't be using all the time.
If the first hit, it seems like it's tight, but if you hit it again, it really does have some more to go. So I may go hit it again, but I guess there's no sense in dragging the camera around there. So I could get my breakover. I think I will. I'm gonna go get my break. The blazer's open, and I can go get my breakover and see. I can tell by feel how tight it is.